So at this point, I thought that if Black gets a bit of time, he'll probably manage to consolidate and he'll be completely okay. So I thought that it's time to break with a move d45, very interesting move. And now there are a few options. One is, for example, to take with the knight. But now I thought that after bishop takes e7, queen takes e7, knight takes d5, bishop takes d5, bishop takes h7, followed by rook takes d5. White is better because black's king is permanently weak, for example, here. Obviously, the pawn on e6 is pinned, so rook h5 is coming with a strong attack. So if you go back to the position after d5, he took with pawn, which I think is the best move. And now the idea was to go knight d4, bring the knight to f5. My opponent was still blitzing his move, played rook e8 here. And this scared me a little bit, of course, because I don't mind to sacrifice a pawn, but I don't like when my opponent plays all his moves without thought. Anyway, I had to continue with knight f5, because why else to give a pawn? And after some thought, my opponent went bishop c5. And after queen f3, my position looked extremely attractive. Knight on f5, strong bishop on g5 as well. But there is some hidden defense here. It starts with the move d4. Here I played knight to e4. And this was the critical moment of the game, basically. It's the whole assessment of the move d4, d5 basically comes down to this position. Here, black could have taken the knight on e4, and if the bishop takes f6, it looks very bad, because queen takes f6, bishop takes e4 is simply an exchange, and white wins. So it looks like black is in a lot of trouble here. But there's this incredible move, rook to e5. I saw this move during the game, but I thought it doesn't work because of knight h6 check. The idea being that if you move the king anywhere, then bishop takes g7 comes. But you can simply take the knight, and if the queen g3 check, there is the intermediate move rook to g5, winning the game. So after rook e5, it's actually quite unclear what I do. Probably I have nothing better than simply taking on d8. He'll take on f3, I'll go bishop c7, and after rook takes f5, bishop takes e5, bishop takes d1, rook takes d1. Endgame is probably around equal. And it's funny that when we reached this position, Indian Nelson, my opponent, actually remembered that this was the position he was aiming for when he was preparing in the morning. He actually had this position on the board during his preparation. I think it went something like, let me think, knight c4, b4, he showed me this line, so d4 and then b5. And okay, position is, I have two bishops, so it's probably just a draw. This was how black should have played. It's not easy, of course, but I was basically quite lucky that my opponent forgot his preparation. If we go back to the position after knight f5, so in the game he played the move rook c8. And now I have many violent options. I can give check on f6, go knight h6, knight g7, bishop f6, all kinds of violent options. But finally, I just decided to go for rook e1. Just very simple, just bringing another piece into the attack. And it's really quite dangerous at this point. I think he should have taken on e4 and played the move g6. I thought that this was the best practical chance, because I didn't see a clear way. The computer actually did show a clear way later on, but I thought this was the best practical try. In the game, rook e6 followed, and now it's actually quite straightforward. I can just take on f6. The idea is that after g takes f6, which seems to attack both the queen and the bishop, I have this move queen to h5, very very important move. Now after f takes g5, rook takes e6, f takes e6, knight h6, check. There's no place for the king. King h8 is knight f7, and if king g7, queen f7, followed by queen h7, mate. So instead, could here, yeah. He could try to move this division. Ftxg5 is not good, so he could try to move queen e8, and now I thought knight e7 is the easiest way to play. With the idea that obviously if you take the knight at any piece, then it's queen e7, queen e8 mate. So let's move king f8, but then I can take on f6. And after rook f6, queen takes h7, the mate on g8 is unstoppable. So that was very important, the fact that g takes f6 doesn't work. It means that black had to take with the queen. And now after queen g3, it's pretty straightforward. Just too many pieces around the black king. He took on e1, takes on e1, queen c6. And now I played him bishop e7 and he resigned. Because, well, the threat is obviously queen g7. And after g6, there are many, most simple is maybe just to go b2, b4. Because obviously black cannot take on e7. And I'm just winning a piece, so nothing left to play for. So that was it. Hope you enjoyed.